Okay, so now we will continue on our review of logs. Because logs are the inverse of exponential functions, properties of exponential functions are also found in logs. Some of the properties that are useful in our class will be discussed in this video. The first property is the addition property. Remember that when you multiply two exponential functions, for example 10 to the second times 10 to the first, which is 100 times 10, which is 1000, you add the exponents, so you can also write this as 10 to the 2 plus 1, which is 10 to the 3rd, which is of course 1000. Similarly, when we multiply the arguments of a log function, for example ab, it is the same as taking the sum of the two logs. This is written as log of a times b is equal to the log of a plus the log of b. This property can be shown fairly easily with the following example. Log of 1000, we know if we do this in our calculator, will give us 3. You can see that 1000, of course, is 100 times 10, so we can write it as log of 100 times 10, which is log of 100 plus log of 10. Log of 100 is 2, log of 10 is 1, 2 plus 1 is equal to 3, so the two sides are equal to each other. You can also do this with natural logs. So ln of 9, for example, is going to be equal to ln of 3 times 3, which is ln of 3 plus ln of 3. And if we were to enter ln of 9 in our calculator, we would get 2.197. And if we would to do ln of 3, we get 1.0986. And there's two of them, so it's this plus that. And that is the result, which is, of course, equal to 2.197 as well. The second property is the subtraction property. In this case, if the argument of a log is a number divided by another number, it's the same as taking a difference of the two logs of the numerator and the denominator. So this is written as the log of a over b is equal to the log of a minus the log of b. Example, the log of 100 is equal to the log of 1000 divided by 10. Since we know that the log of 100 is equal to 2, our answer on this side also has to equal to 2. Now if you look carefully, the log of 1000 of course is 3, and the log of 10 is 1. So when we write it as the log of 1000 divided by 10, it's the same as writing log of 1000 minus the log of 10, which is 3 minus 1, and of course that's also 2. And again, it's also possible to do this with natural log. For example, in this case, ln of 100 is going to be equal to 4.605. Now we can write 100 as 1000 over 10, which is then becomes ln of 1000 over 10, which is ln of 1000 minus ln of 10 by the subtraction property. If you do calculation in your calculator, ln of 1000 is 6.908, ln of 10 is 2.303. You take a difference of these two numbers, you get 4.605, which is exactly the same number if you were to just calculate it ahead. The third property is the power property. When the argument of a log, for example a, is raised to a specific exponent, for example b, then this is the same as writing b times the log of a. This is written as follows, and an example is immediately right below it. Log of 100, we know it's 2. You can write this as also log of 10 to the power of 2, and you take the 2 and put it to this back side, so it becomes 2 times the log of 10. The log of 10, of course, is just 1, so then your answer is 2 times 1, which is equal to 2. You can do the same thing with ln. Ln of 9, we did the calculation earlier, but this can be written as ln of 3 squared, which is 2 times ln 3. Ln 3 is 1.0986, so 2 times ln 3 would be equal to 2.197. And when you do ln 9 calculation directly in your calculator, you also get 2.197. The last component I want to mention, or the last property, is just if you were to have the same number in your base and your argument, then your exponent has to be 1. This should be fairly easy to see. So if the log of 10, of base 10, has to be 1 because 10 to the power of 1 is equal to 10. The log of e with base e is also equal to 1 because e to the 1 is equal to e. Of course, what that means is that the ln of e is equal to 1.